nothing, it seems, can stop the great mining loot. It started with the 104 companies mining in excess of their sanctioned limit to make illegal profits. Then when the CAG caught them in the act, the state was forced to impose a 68,000 crore fine on them. That brought the centre into the picture. As it turns out, to only assist the companies in their loot. Even after the Shah Commission clearly exposed the illegal mining, a somnolent state government took a long time to act against the companies.
Now the notice which has been issued to different mines in recent past, in all those cases it has been observed that they have already exceeded that limit. And they have produced more than what was actually authorized. So that is how on the overproduction the notice has been issued. As per the section 21(5) of MMDR Act, where in fact the provision is if any mineral is raised without any authority, without any lawful authority, then the cost price can be recovered from the...
This is how the centre is ensuring that it's business as usual for the mine owners. In July 2012, just after the state government sent its notices to the mining companies, the centre changed the rules to now say that mining is illegal only when it's done outside the leasehold, which means that all the excess mining for which the companies were fined has now been made legal since it was done in the allotted mines. The jugglery between the centre and the state has worked perfectly well for the mine owners.
The Government of India at the central level, they undertook this change of rules to benefit those 104 miners who were under the cloud, who were under investigation.
The Odisha government's actions have been suspect all through. It sent the demand notices before sending show cause notice, leaving a legal exit for the mining companies. The mega mining scam certainly has its roots in the state, but it's being well and truly nourished by the centre.